This is Blood Bowl 7 Talk of Battlevision. I'm your host, Wilhelm Wolfsbane. Welcome back, sports fans, to the final game of the final round of the Brew Bowl, a Blood Bowl 7's tournament proudly sponsored by Bugman 7X. Tonight's game is going to feel like playoffs already, with both teams playing elimination football. It's all the excitement and drama of a playoff match, but with the added insanity of a giant steel cage. Nobody does Blood Bowl better than the Brew Bowl. Let's look at tonight's teams. First off, we have our home team, the Axtotl Coattles. Fresh off a victory in an exhibition match, last week, the Coattles are looking to extend that streak into the final round of the competition. The season itself has offered mixed fortunes for the Coattles, with three wins, a single draw, and three losses. They need a win tonight to put them through to the playoffs. Standing in the Coattles' way are the Kislev Outcasts. The Outcasts come in tonight with an identical record of wins and losses to the Coattles. Though the fact that almost every single win or loss on their record is a 1-0 scoreline, their overall goal difference is slightly greater than the Coattles, meaning that the Outcasts will go through the playoffs tonight with either a win or a draw. But who plays for draws, am I right? In any case, tonight I'm joined in the studio by both team managers. So let me say welcome to you, both Mo Jadden and Ia Ira Eldenkin.
Pleasure, as always.
Mo, I'm going to start with you tonight. I'm sure the team has been feeling pretty good coming off the back of their victory against the Khemri City Scarabs in an exhibition match last week. Axtotl Temple City remains a home to the Lithuanian and is in fact our venue for the evening. You also had a win last round in the competition, so as mentioned before, training is really starting to pay off some dividends for your team. Taking all of this into account, how do you feel going into tonight's match?
I'm feeling pretty all right. The lack of referees on the field is kind of concerning, but that is what it's going to be. So we'll see how that happens. Yeah.
And yeah, Ira, you're usually pretty hard to get a read on. You've got such an eclectic team, it's always not easy to tell which direction you're going to go, especially on the field. You've obviously lost one of your big girls going into tonight's match, and I can see that a bit of the ERI we know and love has come out with a great mercenary hire for the match. Do you think the team has what it takes tonight to bring victory and a playoff position?
I very much believe so. I believe our track record has shown that, and I think we're just going to do what we did last year, lose to Goodrick and win in the final round to get in.
Now, Mo, it's good to see the Coattles' loyal fan club, the Rules Lawyers, have joined us here again in the Axtotl Temple City. However, no amount of vocal hooliganism is going to sway a referee that is separated from the action by 2 inches of solid steel. The refs are out, which means dirty plays are in, and I suspect your opponents have no intention of demurring from throwing the boot in when given the opportunity. How does that change your game plan this evening?
Well, I guess the way to look at it is if the things that make something against the rules is not there, then I guess it's part of the rules.
Yeah, Ira, I'm sure I'm not speaking out of turn when I say that I suspect the Outcasts are going to look to use the cage to their advantage. Does its presence change anything else about your team's game plan?
I don't believe so. I mean, if someone gets pushed into the cage, they would have got pushed into the crowd anyway, so really doesn't make too much of a difference. It just means the ball won't be going as far if it gets knocked off to the sideline.
So normally at this point in final interviews, I like to take a look at where the teams and players have ended up on the individual leaderboards for key statistics. Mo, other than some uninteresting stats around player pays, the only place I see a Coattles player on the individual leaderboards is your runner, Starboard Date, who is currently in equal third place for the most times injured during the season. Why do you think individual Coattles players haven't risen above the masses? I felt for sure early on that Tiny would appear on the casualty board.
We hadn't had that kind of luck with the casualties for Tiny or any other source blockers. And I kind of spread out the touchdowns for everybody, and my guys aren't really good at completion except for the one time it happened. Even then, it wasn't for any touchdowns.
The situation is even more dire for the Outcasts. Once again, with the exception of a single pay statistic, no Outcast player appears anywhere on the leaderboards, good or bad. I'd like to know, Ira, what you put that down to. Your team hasn't been without their successes, plus you've had a top-notch thrower on your team all season long and some of the toughest big guys. What's holding the players back?
Well, we're are obviously more of a defensive focused team. Of course, the team itself is near the top of that leaderboard. I believe we can't finish on top of that one now with the Dwarves having played their final game, but we are in the top five for that. And I think that's where a lot of our focus has been.
And looking across the field at each of your opponents, I wanted to start by asking you, Mo, the Outcast recently dropped down to a single big guy, which could have caught you can of course match with your Croxigore. Your blockers outstrength their players and your linemen outrun them. What is it about the Outcast that you think will be most intimidating for your team or have the most impact on this match?
It's more the fact the willingness to foul in the match than what I typically am. Obviously, again, like I said before, if the refs aren't going to be here, then fouling might as well just be another extra play. But it's still fouling, which is just not clean, not nice.
And, yeah, Ira, you certainly handled teams that are stronger than yours in the past. You dispatched the Knights in round 3 and the Butchers in round 6. Your track record is a little sketchy when it comes to fast teams, having taken losses to both the Enslavers in round 2 and the Blight in round 5. What is it you need to do to keep those skinks under control during this match?
Knock them down early and hope they stay down. That tends to be our biggest issue with the speedy teams is hitting them. And if we can hit them, of course, we're no strangers to fouling, so we might also factor that into our playbook.
Very well. All right, we need to get this match underway soon. So, Mo, is there anything else you'd like to add? And please don't waste your breath hoping for a clean match.
That's it. I was just going to waste my breath hoping for a clean match.
anything else you'd like to add in?
Good luck to my opponent and hope for a dirty match.
There you have it. All right, sports fans, it's been a hell of a season. 63 games have come and gone before this one, but no game is more important than tonight for the two teams we're about to watch. Win and you're in. That's what both teams need to keep at the front of their minds as they stride out to do battle tonight inside a steel cage. I'm excited to see what both teams can do under such intense pressure. So let's stop talking and get to watching. It's Blood Bowl time. All right, over to the field, and we will start off with some rolls. So, Pondo, let's have a corporate roll from you, please.
Excellent. That's a plus one. I'm going to take it that that the one move I have that sends a player off automatically, that'd be a six in total.
Okay, so it's my 100 points. Yeah, so the do you mean the...
I can't remember what the name of it was, but essentially if they do a foul and score a casualty higher than a KO, it automatically sends the there.
So you mean from your stadium? You mean?
No, it's from. You mean from the playbook? Former official playbook.
Okay, that's a good. I looked at the wording of the fan one for the stadium, and that wouldn't apply here. But yeah, if it nullifies a playbook ability, I would think that
if
that,
it does, it does.
Yeah, I think it probably would under the circumstances because it yeah. It's like turning a roll to see if they're sent off into they're actually sent off, and there is no roll here that would convert as such.
All right.
So, Lawson, a Spottish, corporate roll, please. Yep.
Is that a flat zero?
Okay,
so a flat middle.
So let's say plus two to find a sponsor or 10k extra. All right, Pondo, a promotion roll for the fans.
That's to be a minus one.
Oh, doesn't matter. You've still got the minimum three. There you go. So you have the maximum number of fans. And Lawson, promotion roll.
Another flat zero for me.
Okay, so you do it normally. Normal. And finally, training for you, Pondo.
Plus two.
Okay, so that's seven. So no loners, no pros. And Lawson, training for you.
Also a plus two.
Seven, eight, nine. Also nothing. No, okay. No. All right. We can start the match in tour play now.
Yeah.
All right. So it's going to be a D3 for you. Well, actually, we don't need to roll D3 because you got the maximum number of fans. And then Lawson, that's you can
three.
Lawson, you can roll a D3.
Oof.
Two.
Okay, that was an interesting roll.
Yeah. okay.
Like Laxy Daisy over.
And D6 for you, Pondo, for the weather.
D6.
Two. Lawson's only going to be spicy on a one, but roll it. That's, there you there go. There it is. So that's very...
We're on the jungle, right?
Very, now, are we using the... unless, Pondo, which one do you want to use? Do you want to use jungle or do you want to use the standard weather chart?
Are we in an enclosed building? What would weather matter?
No, it's just
it's not a cage around. It's still open roof.
Okay, yeah, it's like a WWE when they lower a cage onto that ring.
It's sweltering jungle, so might as well do it in sweltering jungle.
All right, let me see what it is in sweltering jungle then.
Before I gotta make
blood
my almanacs downstairs.
42.
So.
I've got it here. That's right. Sweltering jungle.
Might just be sweltering heat because I think.
Sudden downpour. Heavens have opened. The players are soaked to the bone, and the ball is very slippery. Apply a minus one modifier every time a player makes an agility test to catch or pick up the ball or attempt to interfere with a pass. Additionally, only quick or short passes can be attempted due to poor visibility.
Good thing I got an elf to still roll a 3+ with someone.
Yeah, exactly. So
I got to break that elf's legs.
All right. So we'll need to update that in tour play in a second. You've got your journeyman in. So Pondo, just accept the no...
inducements.
No inducements, and then for you, Lawson, because we just put in your mercenary, and we'll do your desperate measure separately.
Desperate measure.
So roll
the roll that now.
Yeah, roll it now, so we don't it's out of the way.
That way, I can write down what it is. Five.
Five, I think, is sports espionage, or five is set piece. So as long as it's a quick or a short pass because of the rain, you've got a guaranteed throw and a catch.
Might have a big guy touchdown.
Sorry, Potter, you're about to say something?
I see he has the mercenary with the dodge and block.
Yes.
And tackle, which is relevant for your skinks. Yeah.
So, can somebody change the weather on tour play to a one and a two? So you say that's the right one on tour play?
You want me to do it?
I think I'm already there.
Okay.
Done. Sweltering jungle. Sun downpour. Okay. Pondo, would you like heads or tails?
Go with heads.
All right. Could you flip the coin, Lawson?
Token.
It's tails. So, Lawson, kicking or receiving?
I will kick.
Okay. So, you're setting up first. Need to cull down to 7 players.
I just need to kick it to change weather immediately.
I'll let the journeyman start this game out.
We've got some live dynamis action here in Discord.
I figured today would be the day you'd more likely to get more people in there. The two people that were most likely to watch were the ones playing yesterday. Bryce Fohammer ain't in there. I am set up.
All right.
And defensive only cancels guard on my turn, right?
Yep.
So it's still in effect when... Nope. Oh, okay. Only when you're on defense does defense work.
How many do I have? I need to put away...
3 guys.
Who did I just put away?
You put away left the data.
This is the one with jump up. I need to keep him.
Yep.
He's the one with defensive.
Grab a guy with only 2 things above his head.
Yeah, I'll get there.
I was just grabbing to grab, essentially.
There we go.
No.
Let's do
these guys 10+. That's good there. That's okay, I ain't breaking those armors.
Not with that attitude, you know.
Right. Where's the ball? There's the ball.
I did a lot of armor breaks the Nemesis game. That was surprising for me.
I'll do here.
All right. Deviate roll. 4-6.
Kickoff first?
No, that happens after the deviate. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. Now you do kickoff, then you do bounce. 4 is solid defense. So if you want to, Lawson, you can set up knowing where the ball's going to land now.
Let's just slide all you guys down. All right, I'm set up.
And then D8, see where it bounces. The 2 is to there.
Back towards you.
All right. Pondo, if you could please start turn one into a play.
Yeah.
And you're off.
Okay.
I need to find an obnoxious whistle sound I can use royalty free for this show.
Let's do...
Can't wait for AP to comment in the YouTube comments how much he hates it.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm just going to immediately move Tech All Free up here. Going to go for it. Does weather cause any negatives to go for it?
No.
Okay.
You're a madman, Pondo. He's out of control.
Okay.
It's like before he's like, I'm not gonna roll any 2+ skills. It's like I'm only gonna roll 2+ skills now.
You know, it did mess up a play last time.
If you don't want to roll 2+, it's a 5+ pickup for not tiny. It's a 2+ the other way.
I think it'd be a 6+ pickup because of the rain.
Yeah. Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
But let's look. I had a source with on the ball, or sure hands.
Yeah.
He got fired eventually.
Is it just the normal rain rules, or is there something else to this one?
It also reduces the distance you can throw a blizzard does. Yeah.
Rain plus blizzard minus the rush issue.
Yeah. Sorry, pointing out a question.
Defensive works on my turn.
On my turn, when you're on defense.
Yeah.
Are you looking up?
I'm getting the exact wording just to because it is one of those ones that is stupidly complicated.
It's during the opponent's team turn, I believe, is what it says in the book. I looked it up earlier.
I think you're right. I'm just getting about the actual wording so that agility skill. That's right. I thought it was general for some reason. Defensive during your opponent's turn, not during your own team turn. Any opposition players being marked by this player cannot use the guard skill.
Okay, so if I attempted to blitz his guy, he would just...
He would still have guard this turn.
The two guards would both apply.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
But if you put your defensive player there, he wouldn't get to use the guard skill on his own.
Right.
Yeah.
So I am going to put him there.
At least until I punch him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, if you punch him, you punch him.
It's like when your opponent has guard, you have to feed the defensive player, clearly.
I couldn't find a ruling. Does defensive work when the player with defensive is being blocked? Or can they mark someone while they're being blocked?
Yeah.
Okay.
I say so.
Okay. Tiny can move. He'll just move here. He'll move here.
Because the question is Lawson, whether the person who is it's their person using the guard skill and they can't use it because they're being marked by someone that has defensive regardless of whether that person's involved in a block or not.
Okay, I didn't know if they still counted as marking when they're engaging in a block.
What would happen if I did Dauntless player blitz into the Minotaur? I think it would just make him the same strength, and you still get the guard benefits.
That's right, yes.
Okay. I'm going to move. Move right block kick here. Okay, so I am going to blitz with Forte Block Kick into Jin Bear Bane.
Yep. So it'll be a go for it. I'll buy a 2-dice block.
Yep. Okay. That's not a good sign.
Nothing but guard on this one, so it's anything to knock him down.
Except push.
Put there. And push right forward.
Yeah.
Okay, that was the crazy part out of the way.
Now for the 4+ pickups.
want to do left Darté. Move him up there. And then attempt to pick up.
4+. He's got it.
Yeah.
Got it. That's one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Jeff. Every part of me wants to be greedy, but I don't think that's a good idea. I get nothing for it. Yep, that's it.
All right. Over to you, Lawson, for turn one.
All right.
Was anyone else disappointed that the fuse kept going out on that bomb?
I was very disappointed. I've used it before in my own personal games, and it's very fun. Milosh is going to block line of free. So two dice with block and tackle.
Do you want to drop him on the spot or move him back?
I do want to push him back.
Does he have block?
Never mind.
Never mind. For some reason, I thought you were smacking with the Minotaur, but I guess he would already have two up.
That is through armor. So normal injury. It's a stun. It's a stunty KO, actually.
It almost rolled over to that 5 on the 1.
Wait, who do you attack with?
The mercenary.
Oh, does he have Mighty Blow?
Who's a POW anyway?
No, he doesn't have Mighty Blow, but it's because stunty players are KO'd on a 7.
You just talked about regular injury roll, and I was confused for a second.
Sorry.
That's fine.
I think it's a force of habit from him. I want to block with who? I'll do Triss into left of Darté.
Okay. You 2 dice. Just a push.
Okay.
I will push them to here. I will. What do I want to do here? The stunty is really going to suck if he has to dodge away. I'll do Fearless Bane into Corte Block Kick.
That'll be 2 dice.
So.
Yes, for Animal Savagery. Oh, sorry, for Unchanneled Fury.
Yeah, Unchanneled.
Ooh.
I will use my manager reroll.
Okay.
That's better.
Still 2 dice on the follow-up.
Yeah. My player decides to move.
Got him.
Ow. Okay. I will go here, and I have to follow up to here.
Yep. Armor.
10+.
Oh, that's true. So you get Mighty Blow on the injury. That is KO.
Bearbane hasn't moved yet.
You're running out of players here, Pondo.
Well, apparently. Only KO is not injuries, so... I guess that's the bright side of it going at the moment.
The funny thing is the 2 players in front of your big guys here are both not on my roster. The mercenary and the journeyman. Alrighty then. Okay. I think I'm going to do it this way. Bloodcloak's going to move 5 to here. And I'm going to try and 2 dice with Real Wentz into Tackle Free. I will use my leader reroll.
Okay. Oh, that's big. That's an important one.
We'll mark him on the Oop, that's the wrong person.
Oh. Armor? No.
Actually, I did not want to put him there. I wanted to put him here.
Yeah, I was wondering when you put him there. I was like, oh, are you sure about that?
Then I will blitz with Jen Bearbane onto Freerunner.
Yep.
One, two, three, four.
Five for the blitz.
Jesus Christ. Well, I'll take them both down.
All right. Here's what it is. All right. Armor roll on Freerunner. Is through. Injury. Is a KO.
There we go.
Armor roll Pondo onto Jen Bearbane.
Okay.
Is not through. D8, see where the ball goes. Please, Lawson.
Just bounce all the way over.
Five. Here. It bounces off Jen Bearbane. Four bounces right in the middle
perfect.
There.
Perfect. Hmm. All right. Beat up my uncontracted players.
Well, that is a turnover. So you can start turn two in tour play, Pondo.
Well, this is unfortunate. Maybe I shouldn't have made contact. That's fine.
I knocked down so many people, and the jump up guy is still standing.
Mm-hmm. So. What I'm going to do, so I'm looking at a six up just to pick up the ball.
Plus four on anything, so yes. Three marks in the rain, so that's, yeah, plus four. You got a nice three down block on my Minotaur, though.
Can you even go three down? I thought I only went to two down.
No, because you're more less than half of mine, so you're three down.
Yeah,
okay. It's just like three up the other way.
So, I'm going to
did burn two rerolls on that turn. So,
oh yeah,
only got one left this half.
So let's do right block kick into Milosh.
Yep. So this should be two dice. Got him.
Yeah.
Anyway, from there. All right. Are you following up?
Sure.
Armor? Not quite. One short.
Of course, this is how I live.
Every single one of my guys is a nine. even the mercenary.
So let's do. See if Tiny moves.
Are you blitzing?
No.
No. Okay. Let me see that move.
Let's see here. One, two, three, four, five, six. Just going to go here. Maybe. There we go. Let's go there. I'm
thought
going
you might be
to
set up a pass there.
Huh?
Thought you might be been setting up a pass there, trying to throw over my line to your Crocs.
Do blitz with Tycall free.
Yep.
Into
Deadblight.
Deadblight has dodge if you're factoring that in.
Does he have dodge?
Yes. But he also is my leader.
Yeah. Well, you'd be throwing one dice against Trisferrigor or two dice against Will.
Oh, yeah, because Rowan's.
Oh, yeah, because he has the assist. Yeah, just going into your human thrower. If I push him, I push him.
Now I got the both down.
Just drop him down a spot.
All right. Armor roll.
This one's going.
That's going through. Yep. Injury. And it's done.
That's done. Okay. Then I guess it's the. Can I leap down to players?
You can, yes.
Enemy players?
Yes.
Yeah. Any prone player. It's still a 6+ to pick up, though.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And it would be a 5+ leap because you're leaping out of two tackle zones. And Stunty only applies to a dodge, and dodge only applies to a dodge.
There's a high chance I'm not going to get it anyway.
I mean, you could try and pick it up and decide from there.
Yeah, let's just get. I got to do dodge.
3+.
Yep. Yep. 3+.
Dodge. 3+.
And then a 6+ pickup.
Yeah. Pickup.
No.
You used your 6. Sorry.
Gonna leave it.
All right. Where's the ball go? 8 is onto Jen Bearbane again. And then it bounces again.
Oh, that ball likes that down line.
8 is going to be there to there.
Right. It's moving in the right direction.
That's a turnover.
Okay.
Over to your turn.
Yep. I will stand up Milos, the Kislev native. I will stand up Bearbane. She is going to be a nice guard piece. I guess it's the best play there is Fearless Bane into left to Darde.
3+.
Unchanneled Fury.
3 dice.
Nice.
That's only a push, but where do you want to push? Because it's going to be a chain push, whichever you do.
Yeah. I think I'll move Rilwentz a little bit more free.
And then 3 dice. Push.
Ugh. I am not taking the post down. Yeah, I'll push you off so you're not involved. So that is 2 assists for Faragor on to tackle free because I got the actually no, the Minotaur does not bump guard.
Minotaur's marked.
That'd be a 1 die.
Yep.
What can I do with core? One, two, three, four, five, six. I had to go for it. Only 2 up. I have 1 reroll left, so I'm gonna do that. Go for it.
You good?
Got it.
Now it's 2 dice.
Triss Faragor is gonna 2 die into tack all free and hope I don't roll both down.
You good?
Got the star. You're gonna go that way. I'm gonna leave my other lineman to die.
So, we're all. Yep.
Not quite. Actually, that's Blood Cloak. I could dodge away. Out of 3+.
So there's no way to dodge through that you wouldn't be a 4+ because you're.
That'd be a 3+ because he's a 2+ normal.
Yeah, but you've got prehensile tail, and you, there's no.
Oh, he does have
dodge
yeah.
to a dodge.
Thank you for reminding me.
Yeah.
Does not have block though, so. Because I was thinking I would just try and blitz left to Darde. I'm going to declare a blitz on not tiny.
Okay.
So 2 dice down.
Interesting choice.
I'll take. Do you want to go down with me, or just want to get knocked down yourself?
I'll take us both down.
All right. Yeah. So, Lawson, you roll armor first on not tiny. Oh, that's true.
Hey.
Injury.
It's at least a stun.
It's a stun, and then Ponder, you roll on Medina Blackcloak. No, it's not through. But it's a turnover.
Yeah, I'm gonna lose this. This is interesting. Okay.
So you can start your
I've already done it.
Yep, awesome. All right, turn it. We need to turn over Rulwentz too. Yeah, done.
So
two chances to get a star.
Let's do two, four, or a pickup.
Five up.
Five up because it's marked in rain.
Or sorry, five up. Round five up. Man, I don't really have much to begin with.
Yeah, picking up the ball is gonna be the hardest part of this game, especially in my patented dog piles.
Yeah. Stand up to call free. I'll be going ahead to. Oh, nope.
Yes. You can move her once over there.
Can
block
I stand
the way
up
a bit.
And foul just for the hell of it.
It'd be a minus, it'd minus be one a foul. Nine.
Can you go negative on
you
fouls?
Can. Yeah, you certainly can.
And there's no need to foul yet. Three up.
Three up.
Normally, you wait for the other person to foul first.
Yep.
One, two, three, four.
Five up.
Five up.
All right, he's got it.
Oh. Hey, got it. You come right back where you left him.
Well, I got to dodge out first. Oh, my God.
Hey,
okay.
The sixes are coming in hot.
So five, six, seven, eight.
Any go for it?
Huh?
Any go for it?
Yeah,
I can hit you even
one.
With two of them.
I want to get away from the edge. I don't know what happens at the edge, but it doesn't sound nice.
If you,
you get into a wall.
Yeah, if you get pushed into the wall, it's a knockdown.
Okay.
A push turns into a both down with block.
There's no point in going to do another go for it. I'll attempt a blitz with right block kick into Milosh.
Yep.
You need a star to knock him down.
I just want to push you away.
Yep.
Push him there.
You following up or not?
Not following up.
Okay. You still got five moves left.
One.
So five, two, three. Five, six.
That's everyone, I think.
Yep.
All right. Crox turns
Let's
over.
All my guys are knocked out.
All right. And turn three for Lawson.
I've started the turn. Two, three, four, five, six. Let me go for it to hit. But he does have loner, which makes that a little bit more difficult. All right. I will. Do I want to stand up blood cloak yet? Actually, I'm not blitzing. Two, three, four, five, six. Yep. To there. I will declare a block with Fearless Bane onto right block kick number two.
Yep. And Channel Fury. You good? Two dice.
Come on, dice.
Got him.
That's a pow.
Got it.
I will push there. I have to follow up.
Armor.
Come on, mighty blow.
Eight, no. Nine.
No, right, you sorry. Don't need any more of my guys. You already knocked out three of them.
I will declare a blitz with blood cloak.
Yep.
I can't get in front of him. So that's three, four.
Two dice.
Actually, it's three dice because I got two assists.
Oh, you're two assists. Sorry. Okay. Well, sorry.
I got the star already anyway. Yep. So
I think you need to re-roll three dice.
I'm going to shove you over here. I will follow up.
Okay, I'm going to roll first. Not through.
That's a one.
Yeah, so the ball goes. Six is onto Deadblight. That goes to D8 again. Three is in the middle there.
It's fine. That is
five so far.
Five. Yeah. I want to try and pick up the ball when I got more stuff to do. Sure. Three plus pickup.
In the rain.
Oh, the rain came through. It's turn three. I'll use my last reroll.
Just delete it.
And hope this doesn't go south.
Oh, just got it.
Nice. All right, that's six movements there. Yep. All right, Real Wentz will stand up. You have leap and guard. I don't know why I gave you leap when I had a choice. Faragor will block tackle free with two dice.
Yep.
Got the star. Just shove you that way.
Come on. No.
Nope. Okay, these two haven't moved yet. So I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Protect myself from the big guys. And Journeyman's going to commit a foul onto right block kick number two.
Plus three.
So I need a 7.
That's through.
Got it.
Regular injury. That's a KO.
KO.
So record a foul for it's for the journey anyway, but you can still record it.
Number 97. They gave him a weird number, just like all of me. And that's all my players. End turn.
Okay.
I got three turns to score, and all your players are on the ground. Good. Mm-hmm.
I'm just going to stand up and blitz with Left Arte into Blood Cloak.
It'll be two dice.
Two down.
Yep. Okay.
Your rolls two pals. It don't matter.
When you take Lawson to push or the both down or Pondo, you give me that roll.
If he's not re-rolling, I'll take the push.
Sure.
So you have to, it has to be pushed to there. Yeah. Following up.
Yep. Sure. I'll stand up, take all free, and then attempt to stand up tiny.
No.
Yep. That's it.
Yep.
All right. Lesson turn four.
How do I want to do this?
Just go for it.
Trying to think who I want to block with.
The meaty man. Because you'll probably end up just pushing him out.
Well, into the wall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Three dice.
That's the only thing that's standing in your way. I can't do anything else.
Sure. Fearless Bane will attempt to block Lefty Darde.
You good?
This almost feels like it should be 10 dice. Got the stars.
All right, armor is through, so you get mighty blow on the injury. Oh, that is a dead skink. Attempt the apothecary?
I'll just leave it.
You sure? Okay. Yep. All right, so.
Casualty granites.
We needed an injury for number 6, Pondo of 12.
All right, 1, 2, I think it's 6 to get to the line because he was on the line. 3, 4, 5, fix to here. I'll declare a, I'll move Jen to here. Declare a blitz with Milosh. Okay. 1, 2, 3. So
two dice.
We both have block. Does not matter. I probably should have gone with Triss there, but I wanted the safety. Real Wins hasn't moved yet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I'll go ahead and Triss 6 and 4.
It goes into the wall, so it's dropped on the spot.
Still an armor roll, right?
Yeah, it's still an armor roll. No plus the wall. Oh, that roll saved him. Yeah, he's fine.
I guess my journeyman will commit another foul.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4. So plus four against another blocker.
That's through. Regular injury though. So it's nice, a KO. Another foul for
Benjamin. Turn into the butchers here, apparently. Did you get like 10 fouls in that game?
Oh, some of that. Yeah, I think it was 9. I think it was 9 in the end, in 12 turns.
You got more fouls in that game than most of us have the entire season. Mending my turn.
All right. I'm just going to attempt to stand up with Tiny.
He's good.
And I'll just leave it there.
All right. So my turn 5.
Yep.
All right, it's 6 movement to get to the line. No need to go for it, because if he goes for it, fails, and is removed, I can't score. Can I get to 3 dice? I need 4 assists. 1, 2.
Wait, how are you going to get to 3 dice?
Well, because he's got 6 on the blitz.
I need 5 assists, actually, yeah.
Yeah.
So I need all my guys.
I guess theoretically, but not likely.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can't get it on the second dice, but whatever. And then let's 4 to there. And we'll declare the blitz with Grannis.
Yep. 1.
Sure.
Everyone set up for it, and he just goes, what do you want, guys?
That is all of my players, so I will end my turn.
All right.
I'll just go ahead and turn over.
Okay, I will start my turn on tour play. And I will not risk anything stupid. Blood Cloak scores.
Okay.
Touchdown, Medea Blood Cloak. Do I finally have someone with multiple touchdowns this season? And that, of course, ends my turn.
Half-time. That ends the half. So, can someone please reset all players? And let's see who comes back out again.
Players. Ooh, I hit the wrong button. Now I gotta wait for the menu to pop up. If it pops up.
Yeah, it's happening now. All right, so. Hondo, that's a nice roll.
Uh-huh.
Does free runner wake up?
Does the path carry help in any of this?
No. Okay. Does line of fray wake up? Yes. Does porter blocky wake up? No. Does right blocky wake up? Yes. And does Cackle Free wake up? Yes. Okay, so you've got enough players to certainly build a 7-man team still.
Got all the sources back.
Yep. I know, except for 1.
I don't know if I have hope here. But oh, no, we'll see. I don't have a lot of confidence.
I mean, it's hard to really do with six players being removed from the field.
Yeah. And all he does is have to... No, that's it.
The guards have really been helpful in this game, too.
I guess. No, you just
it, got it set up so much. It was... The guards were good in the opening portion of that half. In the second half, you didn't have enough players for it to matter.
It saved your Minotaur, definitely.
Yeah. All right, I'm benching my Dark Elf now.
You're setting up to kick off, Pondo. I wasn't sure if that was your setup or if that was just putting the players out.
That was me setting up for kickoff.
Okay, cool.
Why do I have 4, 5, 6, 7? Okay, it's just because I have 4 and I'm trying to make it even. Sure. That's my formation.
All right. Pondo, where is the ball going?
Let's do it right here. Why not?
All right. Deviate roll.
No for the blitz.
2 to 8. 1, 2. And
that's good for you.
Kickoff event is high kick, so you can teleport someone under the ball, as Pondo says.
Oh, do I really want to?
You don't have a reason not to.
I do have a lot of reasons not to.
Sure.
I could just end my turn with my formation like this. Sure, I'll move Milosh onto the ball, because he can always retreat.
He cuts the ball. All right, so... and then you can start your turn 7 in tour play, Lawson.
Start turn. One, two, three, four. I will declare a blitz with Grannis.
No.
He will stand there looking menacing.
At least it's still a tackle zone.
Narvas will go to the front of the line. Triss will go to the front of the line. And Deadlight will go to the back of the line. I will end my turn.
All right. Pondo, turn 7.
Okay.
I'd really like to have the Minotaur standing there right in the front.
You don't have anything to worry about. I've got nothing against you right now.
Now you can start breaking through.
I'm going to blitz with Tycalfrey into Soulbreaker.
Okay. 2 dice. Got him. Has to go there.
Push from there. Step forward.
Armor roll.
See if Tiny moves. If he doesn't, then...
Oh, the armor roll first as well. Yeah, you can move him still. Just do your armor roll. Okay. That's not through.
Not.
I knew it wasn't going to be through.
Where? Who is who? You're the Nerves of Steel guy, so you're not important.
None of my skinks are important.
Well, the defensive one is.
Nerves of Steel is actually pretty good, to be honest.
Defensive doesn't benefit me, really, at the moment. You're stacked too deep.
I mean, you can mark Bear Bane, but I can still try and block you away.
It's the problem with defensive on a skink is that it's so easy to remove. Same with having guard on a little guy.
That's what dodge is for.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mistarget them.
I'll leave it there.
Can the Minotaur catch a pass while he's under Unchanneled Fury?
He has the tackle zone, so yes, he can.
I'm thinking of potentially just going, using my set piece to give him the ball. All right, my turn. I will stand up Narvas. What do I want to do? It would be two dice with Bearbane or Milosh into Tackle Free. But I kind of want Milosh to not be the one to make the block, even though he has block. It would be one die with Cordeno into Not Tiny. I got my leader reroll back. So I'm back up to two rerolls. I will do Jen Bearbane into Tack All Free.
Okay. Two dice.
I will take the push. I will defensive guys all the way over here, so he's not using a skill. Follow up. I will declare a blitz with Granis into Not Tiny.
Okay.
Jesus Christ. That's not fun. Okay. I'll move Real Wentz up. Not that far.
In the middle there.
So that's three assists for Milosh into Not Tiny. So it's two dice. I have block, so I will knock him down on the spot.
Okay, overall.
And hopefully that is broken.
No.
Not anywhere close. I have already used my blitz. Narvas stood up. So I got these two left. Guard will work even though he's marked. So one, two, three, four. So plus four, I'm going to have Triss foul Not Tiny.
So it'll plus four minus two. So you'll be at plus two total.
Okay. So it's still better than a 10.
Yep. Yeah. Eight, 19, got just got it, yep. Injury.
So that at least stuns him, which is what I really wanted.
It stuns. That's a...
It's a foul for Triss.
Yep.
Sometimes all you need is the stun, because that's now two plays, really. He's not doing anything. What is Cordeno going to do? Anything? I'm going to take a step back. And that will be a end turn. All right. Five more turns of defense.
No, you really just need two more. And I won't be able to beat you or tie with it. Because I mean, I got to win no matter speed. What. And I think you... Because I'll still have to kick to you, which you can just stay in the back.
Now, if I score, I kick to you.
Yeah, but if you score, then his chance of winning versus his chance of drawing. That's what he's talking about.
I don't think I'm gonna win by four to jump Dunamis.
Yeah.
So,
well, it's again, it's a matter of can I get two touchdowns on you, and I don't think I can.
I mean, if you get really lucky with the eight movement, you can score two turns on defense, but you're gonna have to get. You have to be able to knock my players down.
That's very optimistic of you.
And the rain's definitely not helping.
I'm going to do right block kick into Triss.
Yep, two dice. Got him.
I got no skills.
Come on, to a play.
Not following.
Okay, I'm roll.
Nine plus.
Nope.
I'd like that Minotaur to do something this half.
Uh, Okay, so I need. I'm gonna bring Starboard Darte. I'm going to use Free Runner to block into Bearbane.
Oh, interesting. Okay, so two dice.
That'll be a chain push.
Yep. Where do you want to push him?
He's down.
Also, where do you want to push? Who are you chain pushing, basically?
I'm pushing them into the bear than that.
No, you can't move a Minotaur. You have to go to here or here. That's if you're pushing Rowents. So then Bearbane will go down here.
Yep. Are you following up or not?
Ooh, I hit the wrong one.
No.
Okay, armor roll.
I'm going now, to blitz with Tycal Free into Milosh.
Did you want to mark Nova Sabra? Oh, yeah, going that way. Okay, no worries. My bad.
He's down.
Yeah.
He's going the wrong way around.
Two, three.
Surprised you didn't follow up with right block kick. That would have served the assist as well.
I don't need it.
I guess if he got a push, it wouldn't have mattered. Yeah.
Push and manage reroll to try to get that.
Manage reroll, yeah. Got him.
Yep. Got the star.
What do you want? Oh, he has to be dropped there.
There.
Are you follow up or not?
Sure.
Okay, an armor roll.
Another 9+.
Nope. Yeah, so where the ball goes. 8 is on Jin Bearbane.
The ball really likes falling onto my down lineman.
2 is onto Real Wentz, who will catch it on it's a loose ball. 5. And 5, yep. Nope.
Does not matter what he would have caught it on.
D8's here it goes. Awesome.
Burp.
4 is to there.
All right. Do your thing, Line of Free.
Yes.
Be a 6+ pickup again.
Yeah, the Nerves of Steel player. Nerves of Steel player had to be involved in
the. The Nerves of Steel doesn't matter.
Nerves of Steel is only on a catch.
Oh, okay.
And a throw. And an interception, which is technically a catch. It's everything but a pickup. That's why it's a passing skill.
I'll do a ball drop of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll do 8 there. Then moves here.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Ain't that make it a short throw? Yeah.
Be a 6+ pickup, a 4+ pass, and a 4+ catch.
4, 5, 6.
Plus. He's got it.
Got it. No, he also has the dodge. I don't have a tackle on him, so he does get that.
Where's the ball? 7.
3+. With a dodge reroll.
Yeah.
Ah. Damn it. All right, I'm Roll Lawson.
I think I just concede.
That's not terrible. Well, it's probably like where the ball goes, because you can see it, at the start of your turn if you're conceding.
One.
Just going to check. I think at the start or end of your turn you can concede.
I thought you could only concede on a kickoff setup.
Maybe.
That's annoying.
Because I remember AP did his wrong when he conceded.
Let's see. Main book.
I don't have the main book on me right now to help look.
Seeding, okay. Start of any of your team turns.
Okay.
Okay, so I have to wait till my turn. Okay.
Yep.
So don't knock you below three players on the field. Got it.
Right, sure.
I will start my turn.
Yep.
What do I want to do?
Where's the prone?
I have two. Okay.
All right. I guess I'll. Well, now that I know you're conceding, I don't really want to do anything because I don't want to risk anything.
That's a smart play.
I will.
He can say he was conceding, and then you go, "Okay, I'm not going to do it." And he stands up, his player picks up the ball and takes the end zone. But I don't know whether Ponder would do that.
No, that does not. That sounds like a dick move.
I will stand up Jen Bearbane. I will have the journeyman make the block then.
Yep.
Two dice on with Cordeno into tackle free.
Yep.
Oh, okay.
I guess I should say if you attempt to pick up the ball and then drop it, then I might try again. But
okay. That's your armor.
See. Yeah, no.
Stunt.
Well, I'm about to say if I killed him, you were going to lose him anyway if you conceded, so. I'd really like to get that set piece off now. Milos will stand up for 3, 4, 5. Baragor will stand up for 3, 4, 5, 6. Jen Bearbane stood up. So I got Narvas and Rilwentz left. And Granis. 6, 7, 8. I can't get to 9 without making some dodges. Ask 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I can get behind him. Be still two dice anyway. Declare a blitz with Granis.
Okay.
Onto right block kick number 2.
Possibly roll 1 third time in a row.
1, 2, 3. I mean, get him out of Channel Fury. 2 dice. I will take the push. We'll follow up.
Still 2 dice.
2 dice. I got the stumble. I will take that one.
Armor. That's through, so plus 1 injury. That's a seriously hurt. So record the casualty for Granis, and I do want to make Apothecary that.
Apothecary that.
So D6. No.
Oh.
You're gonna record 11 for number 12.
Now, Devil's Advocate. I mean, seriously hurt and badly hurt are the same thing right now.
Yeah.
So I got Narvas here. 1, 2. Rilwentz will declare a pass, and I will declare my set piece because I put that on activation. So I got
4 plus.
Yeah. 4 plus. I got my reroll still. I will use my reroll.
No.
Oh.
Where's the ball go?
And hope the ball goes to 7.
5. It goes onto the unconscious skink and bounces again. D8, see where it goes.
I rolled a D6, I think.
You did.
And it goes to 2.
It does go to 2.
It does go to 2.
Yeah.
Did not it's still marked. All right, that is, of course, turnover.
Yeah.
You have 6 players on the field.
Declare blitz with line of free, hope for two died down, hope for a push you out of the way. And
I mean, you've got a loose free runner is loose out here, could go and assist on something as
yeah,
well.
So. I'm trying to think what's better, a five up to pick up or yeah, let's just go ahead and because it's one, two, three pick up. Yeah.
He's got the ball.
Why the hope?
Free up. With a reroll if necessary. With a reroll if necessary.
You can roll double twos again?
No.
No.
Oh, got it. Touchdown.
I guess I got it.
Yep. Touchdown for ball dropper.
Very well.
Very well, Dice. We will play your game. All right, we're gonna reset all players.
Oh, I hit my team only.
Oh. All right.
I'm just gonna stand on top of you.
Does Porter Blocky wake up?
I kind of need him too.
Yeah. Unfortunately, not though.
Okay, I'm boned. Okay.
Okay, so Ponder, your thing up to kick off.
Yep.
Are you subbing Medina Bloodcloaking back in there, Lawson?
I think I will just to be on the safe side. Because three turns is very reasonable.
I'm a goblin team now. What are you talking about?
I mean, you still haven't fouled yet, so.
No, because you can't throw your players.
Do I have eight players?
You have.
I mean,
no, you got seven players.
Seven. Okay.
Wait, I think you might.
No, I can't knock down your guys, so there's no point in me fouling.
You got to put one more guy on the line, though.
Oh yeah, that's right. This guy.
All right.
One's been injured the most.
Well, the second most. Equal third. Sorry, most injured. That's right.
But he's been injured the most on my team.
Oh, that's true.
Yes. Knocked down, but gets back up. There's even one match where I apothecaried him, and they just got knocked down again.
All right, Pondo, where are you kicking the ball?
Let's do here.
For marking.
All right, deviate roll.
Come on, touchback.
1-4, and then a 2d6 for the event.
One blitz.
That's another high kick. You guys keep kicking the ball way too high. Who are you bringing out there, Lawson? You get to also do your on the ball too, and then have a.
Oh, I forgot about that last time.
Yep.
I'll do 1, 2, 3. Real ones will go onto the ball.
All right, for a 5+ catch. No, where's it go?
Not as lucky this time.
2-7 in front of her.
7.
Yeah. Then you can start your turn 10.
All right, start turn. 3 turns of defense. You know, I feel like it's scored on more when I receive the kickoffs than when I kick it myself.
Well, already, Lawson, your prediction of a 1-0 win to the away team has been scrapped.
Well, there's only been one game this season where a team has scored 2 touchdowns, and that was my turn 12 touchdown against the Vampires.
Yeah.
So I still have that going for me. All right, let's see if I can figure out where Granis is before I do anything else. So I'm going to declare a blitz targeting not Tiny. And he's going to go stand in front of the ball.
Such a bizarre thing. Wondering where the blitz went. Blitz without blitzing.
It's like moving in Battletech.
Yeah, that's what gives me those vibes. 100%.
It's a resource.
It's just. Man, this is a big huddle for it to someone drop the ball immediately.
Just a big, essentially conga line of balls being thrown around.
I mean, if you blitzed either corner of the cage and knocked them onto the ball's going somewhere.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, I am going to end my turn.
All right.
Interesting. I figured you would have tried to get the ball, but that interesting.
No, I don't want to move it yet. I want to make you move it.
That's fair.
This is the plan I have if I had a player with Fumble Rooski get the ball, was just to set the ball up like in the wide zone over here and just gather around it.
I have no reason not to go for Broke at the moment. I'm going to attempt a blitz with Tech Caulfrey into John Bearbane.
I mean, you can get to the ball with your stunnies if you want to.
I'm good. But
exactly 8 movement
yep.
to get started bore.
No, right. I'd rather just play ball roulette at the moment.
Do you 2 dice? Average and MSW. Got him. Okay. You following up?
Sure, why not?
Okay. Armor roll. That's not through. D8, see where the ball goes. Start the insanity. 6, it's on to him. he will catch the ball.
Catch on a 6.
On a 6,
that's
yep.
That's the most preferred outcome of that, to be perfectly honest. If he catches it, that's a problem.
No,
okay.
Where's it go next? 7, back there.
Yeah, look at that.
Still a 5 plus. Because you don't have no more blitzes.
See if Tiny moves.
He does.
He does. Say hi, even though it doesn't matter.
You surround the ball now. So if you do fumble, at least someone might have a chance of catching it. You end up with these 2 giant piles of the ball go everywhere.
Just a series of 5 pluses. The ball bounces between his players.
That's a good idea.
Just taking my move and doing it against me.
5, 6, 7. 8. Come on. There you go.
I don't want to go there.
I don't really care about defensive at the moment. I'm going to put him there.
I mean, putting defensive onto Milosh would at least mean that you wouldn't get 2 dice from Gratis, but Milosh
not unless
would
he
just
use my blitz.
Yeah, but Milosh would just probably hit the defensive player away.
Yeah.
No, it's it's a nice initial annoyance for you. That's about
especially
it.
Especially since he's got tackle, which makes it a whole much easier to get rid of him. I'm gonna laugh if you fail to pick up and I catch it with my Minotaur.
At that point, I just conceded my. Listen, I have to get the ball this turn, or else I can't get it at all.
You got that 2 turns as long as you have a player that can catch it within 8 squares of the end zone, or 10 because you got 2 rushes.
I have bad pass game, and I need a short or a quick pass or something like that.
Yeah.
So it's 12 for a touchdown from here. So as long as you got a player here or farther, you can score in 1 turn.
Starboard Darte. Now let's do.
At that point, you can just try a handoff.
That's what I'm thinking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 for annoyance. And we'll attempt a handoff with Starboard Darte. Boy. 2. He's got enough movement to make it to Sprint Tripper.
5 plus.
5.
No. So where is the ball going now?
Do you have any more manager rerolls?
No, I only have the 1.
Yep.
All right. D8. 2.
5. Okay, on to Line of Frey, who will catch on a 5. He does.
Okay.
Yeah, but
he's got the ball.
It's not a turnover because the ball didn't hit the ground, so you can still move.
It is a turnover on a failed pickup.
Sorry? Oh, failed pickup. Sorry, that's right. Yeah, failed pickup.
If he was doing a handoff and it moved to another guy, it wouldn't be.
Yeah, you're right. Sorry. Okay. So, onto your turn 11 there, Lawson.
I mean, I don't think it would have mattered. All he would have had left was Sprintipore, Strintipo, or whatever his name is.
Rintripa.
I have my leader reroll left. That's it.
Yep.
No, I thought you used that.
No, no, I used my leader in the first half.
Yeah, you get an NH half.
I thought you used it on.
I used this reroll. I thought.
Yeah, he used. Oh, okay. Yeah, he used the team reroll.
I can't keep track of how many rerolls people have.
Well, hopefully I don't need to use it and no one will come in the comments and say we screwed that up, but I don't believe I've used it this half.
You probably haven't.
Damon's watching live. He can tell
us. Maybe Damon will tell us. I could try Triss into Free Runner to start. That's good enough for me. I will stand up Jen Bearbane. I will do Cordeno into Baldrappa. That's still fine with me. Don't want to do anything yet. Oh, that's a dodge still. I will do one assist. I'm still up. It would be a one die on the second with my current position. Do I want to do that? I think I have to. I'm going to try Granis into Tackle Free as a block.
Okay. He's good.
Thank you. All right. It's a two die into a one die if it's a push. I will have to use my leader reroll.
All right, so 4+.
Loner.
No, that's big.
All right, he goes down.
Armor roll there, Pondo.
My goodness.
That is not through. He's a 10, I believe. No, he's a 9. He's 9. Okay, it's through. Sorry.
All my players are 9s.
So
the first injury of the match, boys.
It's a KO. Oh, no, he's 6 gold, yeah. So it's a stun.
Stun. He's still 2 turns. He's done for the game because he's just there on the field still.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Well,
so start your turn 11 into a play there, Pondo.
Yeah.
Can't score this turn at least, so that's good for me.
Well, you could score with some rolls. Would be tough rolls, yeah.
If he tries to hand it to Free Runner, he could. But he doesn't have to score this turn.
You say that. Does Nerves of Steel make it 3 up to catch? Or is it still affected?
It ignores markings. It would still be a 4+ because of the rain.
Yeah, the rain. The rain still applies.
Because it's a handoff's a catch.
Yep.
Still be a coin flip.
Well, am I better off? Well, no, I'd be a 2-die block onto.
Yeah, because you got all these assists here.
Be a 3-die.
No, because it'd be strength 4 because guard comes into play. Right. Yep.
I forgot Jen was marking.
No, I've got
it. It'd be a 4-die if he moves up Sprintipa. He brings up Dagobah back there.
You said a 3-die if I move him up?
No, because it would still be only you only be 8, so 4, 5, 6, 7. And
oh,
because
I do get a plus 1. I forgot that gives me a plus 1. I thought it took away.
Yeah. So
ignore me, I'm not doing math correctly.
Because otherwise I'd do a 3-up, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or I could do a 2-die block.
If you wanted to score right now without doing anything, it'd be line of free making a 3+ dodge, 4+ handoff, and free run of making a 3+ dodge for the win.
Yeah. Sorry, I'm trying to think in the math in my head, which is the safer. Because worst thing, if I get a push with Tycall into core, he's just in the way.
Yeah, I mean, you can still push him to there and follow up, which gives you a 2-dice block with ball dropper. But
I mean, it's always a 3-die dodge with Stuntsy at least. So even if he's in the way, it doesn't hurt too much. It would just make you roll an extra time.
So
or two,
let's go ahead and do 2-die block with Tycall free into.
Plus, yeah. I don't have block on him, so.
Yeah. I'll take the both down, which will just knock him on the spot.
Amaral.
Sure you don't want the player down?
No, I'm good.
Nope.
No, I'm good. Man, this is too much hope.
If you get it, you win, because I can't score in one turn without some really good luck on the kickoff die, and you're not going to get that.
You make it to the playoffs without me if we draw.
Yeah,
you have to score to win.
Yeah.
Yeah. So,
but if you do score, I lose and I'm out.
Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six, seven, eight. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. No, I miscounted that.
Why are you going backwards?
You don't have to dodge back anymore.
No, I'm counting sprint tripper.
Okay.
Oh.
As a safety net? I was going to try to get him there, but I don't know if I can. 2, 3, 5, 6.
That would be 9 squares to get there without a dodge.
Yeah.
I'm so trying to create a settle with blitz here. Out.
Yeah. I think you can actually make it. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah, ball dropper can definitely make it.
Ball dropper will go here. I'm not going to activate Tiny.
Okay.
And then... Eight.
Yep.
Or I'd be better off there. No, I think there. For him. And then I do my play.
Playing a handoff?
Yeah, playing a handoff with line of free into free runner.
Is that where you want him to finish his turn?
Yeah, I'm fine with that. It's over anyway. If you,
all right. Where does it go? 7 goes seven back onto Sprint Tripper. He'll catch it on a 5 now.
Mark plus rain, so yeah.
No,
well, actually, okay. It's 6.
Goes again.
Mark, rain, and
loose ball. Yep. The 7 goes back
seven
to there.
Him.
It's not great.
I think that might seal the deal with me.
All right. Awesome.
Turn 12.
So now that you've done that, Pondo, I would say that I would have actually, like, just tried to run down the field and, like, hope you had no one to get around. Yeah, to
go for the turn 12
yeah,
touchdown.
I guess I probably...
tell you didn't have to score this turn.
Right. Well, it is what it is.
Yep. I thought you were going for that when you started to like mark up the rest of this group here to make sure that none of them could get away without a dodge. Yeah.
You know, I
think he was just marking up
the,
in case.
Get it now, or else I'm not going to get it at all.
Yeah.
Which is probably what
I thought this was more
now.
Of a backup plan in case this exact thing happened.
Yeah.
It is hard for me to get over there. Yeah. 1 die block if I'd stand him up.
I mean, Medita Blood Cloak's unmarked.
Yeah, I know. It's. I have an idea of what I want to do, but I'll stand up, Denno. I think I'll declare I'm going to move Blood Cloak first. One. There's no way to get to the ball. Fuck. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. I'm going to declare a blitz with Rilwentz onto Starbordate.
Mm-hmm. Two dice. Push.
I will take that push. You go that way. That's a little too far. I'm not playing on ice. It's one, two, three. Jen Bearbane into Tackle Free.
Yep. Two dice. Got him.
I got him.
I'll shove you that way. I don't really think it matters if I follow up or not, so I'll just go ahead and do it.
Armor roll? No.
I'll do, I gotta do this first. I'm gonna dodge with Milosh.
Four plus.
Oh god, he's got prehensile tail. You reminded me. Oh.
I think you need to do that anyway.
Are you just trying to get as many marks on the ball as possible to make the ball impossible to pick up, basically?
I mean, if I go here and then go here, it's still a four plus there.
Yeah.
Because I'm dodging into a tackle zone. I'll do the block with Faragor then first onto Sprint Rippa.
Okay.
I don't know why I rolled a d6. Some two dice block.
Got him.
Oh, got it.
That was my unchanneled fury roll. Knock him down there. I'm not going to follow up.
Armor. Not through.
Do have the dodge reroll at least, so I will dodge to here.
Four plus. Nope, with a reroll. No, there he goes.
All right. He's serving the same purpose whether he's there or on the ground.
Not through the armor.
Oh. Okay.
Doesn't look good, Pondo, but let's see what you've got. Turn 12. Such an emotional roller coaster this game.
First half went by so fast too.
Yeah, I think I just go for it. God, I should have just stayed. I don't know why I didn't.
It's a six plus pickup if you don't move any of my guys.
I guess
you do have a blitz.
I'm going to try to block with Tiny.
It's good. Yep.
I'm going to block into Bearbane.
Yep. Got him. Has to go there.
I'll follow up. Why not? Doesn't matter.
Armor. That is through with Mighty Blow, so regular injury. That is a serious injury. So that's a casualty for not Tiny. You've got no apothecaries, do you there, Lawson?
Nope, I have not taken anything for injuries. Which one was that?
Jen Bearbane takes an 11.
The one with skill.
Yeah.
Is going to miss the first round of the playoffs if I'm able to hold on. Still a 6 plus to pick up. That's all that matters so far.
Plus regardless now. I'm going to see if I can. I'm going to do a blitz with Tech All Free into Cordino.
Knock him out of the ball.
Either knock him onto the ball.
Would give you an extra chance, yeah.
Yeah.
All right, two dice.
Give you a free pickup roll.
The push.
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 Run to the ball, okay. And see where the ball goes. The
ball first.
Yeah, I got the ball. Five, it's there.
Five is right up on the sideline.
Yeah.
So it's a dodge onto the ball, a 5+ pickup, a dodge out, and you definitely would have to do a handoff. And at least
be a four up handoff anyway.
Yeah, let's.
Yeah.
So a single player could get in by doing a 1, 2, leap, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Go for it. It's a stupid number of rolls, though.
It'd be a 4+ leap versus a 3+ dodge and a 4+ handoff.
Yeah.
Well, I'm doing 2 dodges anyway.
Yeah.
I'm doing a 4+ anyway.
It would be the exact same, actually.
Yeah, so declare the handoff regardless.
I would do 1 less dodge. That would be the determining factor.
First part is picking up the ball, though.
Yeah, let's...
Okay, so 3+ dodge. You could.
Yeah, got it. Handoff, I need that for
that
the handoff.
Five
Wait, pick up, you mean. Yep. Okay, he's got the ball.
Okay.
3+.
This is where it fails.
It's good. Okay.
Oh, my goodness.
Then a 4+ handoff. That's a handoff.
Jesus Christ.
I know. This is 3+.
Dodge.
Yep, that's touchdown.
3+ if he makes this one.
No.
That's it.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Oh, Lawson. Sorry, I don't know what to say. That was absolute insanity. So free runner, that's a touchdown.
Human Christmas. Oh, my blood pressure.
Good luck with Lord Hunger, I think. That's gonna be even worse.
Down my source, that's a problem.
Ugh.
I can't just fire a source and rehire one, right?
You can. You've got the money. You don't get your money back for the one you fire. But all right.
I don't know if I care at this moment. I kind of... Because he has, like... I'll have to think about that. I don't know, because his vampires are all 4 strength, right?
All of them, yeah.
But his thralls are... I haven't really looked at his team, to be perfectly honest. I didn't think I'd get this far.
All right, so if we can... he's dead. Anyway, so we need to intuit play end the match. So Pondo, end your turn first, and then end the match.
Oh, yeah. I did in a match on my end. Oh, no, I need it.
In the turn, then in a match. I think Lawson needs to end it too. There we go.
Got it.
All right, let me edit these quitting players first up before we go any further.
Yeah, I forgot. How do I ditch sponsors?
You can just say you wanted sponsors. That's fine. All right, so first off, let's do a management role, please, for you, Pondo.
+1.
So you can make one player immune from the draft. So draftable players are these ones.
Tech all free,
okay. So roll the dice for Porter Blockick. 1d6.
I thought I pressed it. Porter Blockick.
Oh, he's out.
I guess it will be hiring a source. That's not good.
Line of Frey. Right, the defensive guy stays. Nerves of Steel guy. He's good. All right, Lawson, management role for you.
Is the role optional?
It is optional, I guess.
I will not make the role.
Okay, he's not eligible.
Is Protege optional?
Yep.
I will not protect him with Protege.
Okay, so.
I think that's your mercenary, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, no, yeah.
Yeah, so.
I thought that was real ones for some reason.
No. So they are the players with skills. Okay, so Jeb Bearbane. It's fine. Medita Bloodcloak. It's fine. And Ruined Deadblight would leave. Bye-bye. All right. So next up is D6 for you, Pondo, for your fan factor.
Okay.
Look for a five.
Oh, it goes up.
Six will work.
So you can put six into a play. D6 for you, Lawson.
I've already rolled it.
Oh, you have? Okay, cool.
I rolled a one.
Oh, nice. And then we're on to player advancement, I believe. So Pondo.
Okay. Can I choose right block kick potentially, or is he can't because he's injured?
He can. You can choose him still. He'll still miss the next game though. So
I guess I need to roll the training roll first.
Yeah, training roll. Plus.
Nope. Right. It'll make it seven, which would be first.
Yeah, pick the first
table with right block kick.
Yeah. So, is that what you want to do?
I'd like to get blocked, but yeah.
Okay. So you're doing a general skill then?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, and you're doing the table that's got block on it.
Yep.
So you want to roll a one. You're good at that.
Yeah.
No. It is frenzy.
That's actually.
It's not terrible.
That's actually fairly decent. I'm not gonna lie.
Yep.
That's not the worst thing I could have gotten sure hands again, which
been awful on a skink, but.
All right, Lawson, we're still going to do you, so how are we doing you?
Random secondary.
Okay. On the Granite Sphere of Spain.
All right, random secondary onto Granis.
And you can pick your skill, can't you? Because you've got.
I didn't roll my training roll.
Yep. That's fine, yeah. So your combination lets you pick whatever skill you want to
give him. I'm just going to give him block.
Okay. Cool. So sponsorship. Were you happy to just take the rolls that they rolled for you in tour play there, Pondo? 2021.
I think so, because it's pretty average, to be honest.
Okay, roll 3d6s, Pondo, to see if any of your players.
Okay, we'll do 2d6 first. Just
yep, they're fine. Nope. And one more. No, you're fine. Nobody offends the sponsor. I think you can both decline sponsors there.
No, yeah, I just said I couldn't get one. Yeah. So
okay.
I don't know if I should take a fourth one. That's.
All right. I think you need to still decline sponsor in tour play there, Lawson.
I've already declined it. I'm on losing residency in a stadium.
Oh, okay. Oh, shit. I don't know how that works. We're not in your stadium, though.
I got booted out. Accept or preserve stadium for 90K.
Just go go preserve, and I'll put the 90K back on.
Okay, cool. The end of match report.
Okay, so go into your teams and do those skills. I need to do some, so 90K for Lawson.
I got Dauntless on my roll. That would not be a useful skill on a
big guy. On a straight five person, yeah, that's it. Okay, edit that.
He already rolled Frenzy, so that's good.
I'll get my full 800K anyway, because I got... How many wins and losses?
You have three wins, which is 20K each, and a draw.
60, 70.
I have 190K. That's a problem.
Right. So, and I need to... So it was Dead Blight who quit.
So I got 70, so I need 130 at the end, so...
And
How does the stadium fund work if you're changing teams?
You can keep the stadium fund that you've got so far.
Okay, so I'm going to put... I got 310,000. Jesus Christ. I'm trying to figure out how to do this so I have all my money for next season. Even though the build I have is only 710.
And it was... you got Frenzy. Okay, cool. So, Pondo, you've got 190. Are you going to buy another Saurus?
I think I have to, essentially.
Right.
So I need to... Do I need to fire...
I didn't Point have. Kick. Sorry, I've already moved him. I've already fired him.
Okay, then maybe I just need to switch things. Yeah. So
can you undo a firing?
Yeah, I can undo a firing. Yes.
So I need to.
But right block kick, the frenzy guy. He should have been. Wasn't he at 11? Wasn't he taken out with injury?
Yeah. So was he not able to get it?
So he can, but if some reason tour play is not showing him as
maybe I didn't record it.
Okay, that's what's missing. Yeah, okay, so I'll add that one in then. It's
that the casualty. Would probably be the issue, but yes, he is technically out.
All right, so
that was, which one was that? That was Porte block kick. So you'd be Porte block kick the third.
Yeah, so it was an injury of 11 for which player was it that had that picked up frenzy? It was
right block kick.
Right block kick. There we go.
I'm picking up two cheerleaders to drop me to 270. And then I'll roll expensive mistakes.
You're fine. Ponder, you're still 5k over the point where you would have to.
Might just hire another skink. Oh, I need to put the third on Porte block kick. Yeah, I think I'd.
I would just roll the expensive mistakes myself, but I've rolled it literally every game for the past six games.
What is it? D3?
It's a D6, and if you roll a 1, you'd lose D3 times 10,000.
Yeah, I'll just
so you'd still have more money than if you bought a skink, even if you get it.
Yeah, and I'll think about it if I even if I do fail it.
Yep, you're good.
So okay. Lawson, you didn't throw a completion, did you? Because the turn that you went to use your throwing thing,
nope.
Okay, so you've got 3 XP for that one. And Pondo,
you'll have to remind me where I'm at because I got 2 last week. So I think I have an upgrade.
62 at the moment. You're at 62 total. So that would because you would have been 59 last time. Yeah. So. And Pondo, you picked up 5.
Playing, winning, 2 touchdowns.
And a casualty. Right at the end there, remember?
Did I get a casualty?
You did, right at the end. You got a
on the mercenary, the guy didn't matter. Right?
No. Jen Bairbane, the one that really mattered if Lawson had gone through, because it was the guard piece.
Oh, that's right, yeah. That was like right at the end there. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. So that should be everything. So, back in the studio, I think that, there's probably like claw marks in Wilhelm's seat where he was like, you know, that on the edge of his seat holding on, you know, and, I don't know what to say. Mo, what a finish. I heard that the team was looking around for a white towel partway through the second half, and then they couldn't find that and played on. And wow, what do you have to say for yourself there, Mo?
So, Mo's essentially just has like this blood pressure machine on him, got a rest oxygen machine attached to him. Like, he just takes off. He's like, that was stressful, I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, it did look like we were just not going to be able to make it, but somehow hope kept coming up and we just kept going with it.
Ira, I don't know what to say to you either. It's like your team played their hearts out there, and I'm shocked. I am truly shocked that this is where the Outcast campaign finishes for the year.
There's definitely things we could have done differently in the second half. But at the end of that game, we made them use everything they had. This didn't go our way.
It did not. But, I mean, it was still such a pleasure having you and your team back once again for the Brew Bowl. Who do you like in the finals then, EOR? Let me ask you.
Gudrick has looked really great with the Dwarves. The Amazons are a very deadly team now, and the Vampires have really turned it up since we beat them earlier in the season. But of course the Drakes are still in the playoffs, so I have to lean towards the reigning champion.
Mo, any thoughts from your side? Are you feeling confident going to playoffs, or who do you think's in there with a good chance other than yourself, obviously?
It's going to be rough with being down a source blocker, but I think if we can make it through next match, we got a good head up since our guy got frenzy, which is going to help with some of the pretty much most of the smaller teams from here on out are fairly small, with the exception of the Rogers on both the Skaven teams.
Yeah, I mean, I believe that your quarterfinal match will be against the Knights, so you'll be contending with 4 vampires there and a bunch of thralls.
Yes. So it'll be tense.
So I have to wait and see. Well, folks, that was the final game of the final round. Next week, we go into the playoffs. What an incredible 8 rounds it's been. So many memories, so much action. I'm looking forward to seeing how this competition comes out. So make sure you stay tuned, because all the playoff series will be live on Cabal Vision and Discord for your viewing pleasure. We'll see you next time. Guys, wow, what a match. I didn't know who I was going for at the end. I just wanted everything to go right for both players, and see how it worked out. But yeah, it was just, what a finish.
It was a lot of poor luck at the beginning for me, and then it kind of just picked up at the end.
I think if I just marked polar up the ball on the turn Pondo was considering conceding, it would have worked a lot better. Because it went from a 5+ pickup to a 4+ pickup because I tried picking it up.
Yeah.
Probably should have just swarmed the ball there.
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't just do that, because that would have...
Yeah, I'm looking at the sheet of paper with set piece written on, and I'm like, I have the free pass. If I can at least get the ball on a coin flip, I can throw it.
Mm.
And then it bounced to the worst position possible.
Earlier in the game, the ball bouncing was always going Lawson's way, but then went in later in the game, like, especially that last bounce from the because the ball was pretty well marked up at the end there in that last turn, and yeah, a different bounce could have made it completely impossible to pick up.
They weren't stunties, it wouldn't have worked.
Yeah,
because you've been rolling 5+ and 6+ dodges all over the place.
Yeah,
I think.
And I said in Discord earlier that stunties would have been what I did.
Yeah.
No, I think it just would have been 4+, 4+, which I think I'd.
Some of your dodges were in the multiple tackle zones. The last ones weren't. Yeah. But some of the dodges to get the ball upfield, I think, were in the two tackle zones at one point.
Maybe. I don't really recall. I think I was going through motions for most of that.
And the Namus confirmed on Discord, by the way, that you didn't use your leader reroll there, Lawson, in the second half. So.
Okay.
Yeah, I've already seen some reactions in there after the game.
Well, of course, Lawson, it's probably the last we see of you, I'm sure, in the Brew Bowl. But it is for the final. So thank you for playing live, but thank you also for playing through the last 8 rounds as well. And plus your Nemesis game.
So be the last of the Outcasts at least, but it won't be the last of Eoira.
Yeah.
She's got one more season in her.
Definitely. And Pondo, of course, you'll be back when I can make a time for us to start the quarterfinals. So what is it? Every time, Pondo, when you're doing nothing, you're running your mouse around in circles on the tabletop simulator board. You did it in BattleTech too.
I'm moving the camera around essentially.
Okay.
I do it in BattleTech. I do it in here. I don't know what's with tabletop simulator. Like, whee!
I just have a pen in my hand for that.
It's like my boss keeps trying to convince me to change from a wired headset to a wireless headset. But I hate having to suffer with the batteries, but I realized my boss likes to lean back in his chair and spin around while on phone calls. You know, and if he had a wired headset, he'd strangle himself. So.
Oh, yeah.
All right, guys, thanks for playing. To the audience, thanks for watching. We'll be back next week with the quarterfinals, but please do jump on the Discord, chat with the players, and don't forget, all of the finals will be live through the Epic Game Real Discord if you want to watch them as they're happening and not be spoiled by tour play. So thanks so much. We will see you next time.